Mary. In today's Gospel, Mary visits her cousin Elizabeth and greets her with the words of the Magnificat. Please stand. O Mother of Jesus, of all mothers blessed, to you may our praises and prayers be addressed. Ave, Ave, Ave Maria, Ave, Ave Maria. When time claimed your body and held your last breath, God raised you to glory beyond pain and death. Ave, Ave, Ave Maria, Ave, Ave Maria. O Mary, all beautiful, clothed in the sun, with you may we share in the victory Christ won. Ave, Ave, Ave Maria, Ave, Ave Maria.
Good evening.
Good evening.
My dear friends, we are proud and happy to welcome Bishop Amal Raj from India, and a friend, and we've been coming here. Of course, last year he was here, and we welcome him to our parish and to preside over this Mass. And also, you'll be here for the weekend Mass you'll be celebrating with us. So, we welcome you, Bishop, to
Thank
our
you,
parish.
Father. Thank you.
Thank you very much. And let us begin our celebrations.
So, good evening. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, in order to offer this Eucharist sacrifice in a worthy manner, let us call to mind all our sins and ask God pardon and forgiveness. Lord Jesus, you are Son of God and Son of Mary. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you are the one foretold by the prophets. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the holy and anointed one. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, heavenly King. O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus, of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy. Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, who assumed the Immaculate Virgin Mary, the mother of your Son, body and soul into the heavenly glory, grant, we pray, that always attentive to the things that are above, we may merit to be sharers of our glory. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns within the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the book of Revelation. God's temple in heaven was opened, and the Ark of the Covenant could be seen in the temple. A great sign appeared in the sky, a woman clothed with the sun, with the moon beneath her feet, and on her head a crown of 12 stars. She was with child and wailed aloud in pain as she labored to give birth. Then another sign appeared in the sky. It was a huge red dragon with 7 heads and 10 horns, and on its heads were 7 diadems. Its tail swept away a third of the stars in the sky and hurled them down to the earth. Then the dragon stood before the woman about to give birth, to devour her child when she gave birth. She gave birth to a son, a male child, destined to rule all the nations with an iron rod. Her child was caught up to God and his throne. The woman herself fled into the desert, where she had a place prepared by God. Then I heard a loud voice in heaven say, "Now have salvation and power come, and the kingdom of our God and the authority of his anointed ones." The word of the Lord.
The Queen stands at your right hand, arrayed in gold. The Queen stands at your right hand, arrayed in gold. The daughters of kings are those whom you favor. On your right stands the Queen in gold of Ophir. The Queen stands at your right hand, arrayed in gold. Listen, O daughter, pay heed and give ear. Forget your own people and your father's house. The Queen stands at your right hand, arrayed in gold. So will the King desire your beauty. He is your Lord. pay homage to him. The Queen stands at your right hand, arrayed in gold. They are escorted amid gladness and joy. They pass within the palace of the King. The Queen stands at your right hand, arrayed in gold.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, Christ has been raised from the dead, the first fruits of those who have fallen asleep. For since death came through man, the resurrection of the dead also through man. For just as Adam in all die, so too in Christ shall all be brought to life, but each one in proper order. Christ the first fruits, then at his coming those who belong to Christ. Then comes the end, when he hands over the kingdom of his God and Father, when he has destroyed every sovereignty and every authority and power. For he must reign until he has put all his enemies under his feet. The last enemy to be destroyed is death, for he subjected everything under his feet. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia. Speak, O Lord, your servant is listening. You have the words of everlasting life. Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Luke. Mary set out and traveled to a hill country in haste to a town of Judah, where she entered the house of Zechariah and greeted Elizabeth. When Elizabeth heard Mary's greetings, the infant leaped in her womb, and Elizabeth, filled with the Holy Spirit, cried out in a loud voice and said, "Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. And how does this happen to me, that the mother of my Lord should come to me? For at the moment the sound of your greetings reached my ears, the infant in my womb leaped for joy. Blessed are you who believed that what was spoken to you by the Lord would be fulfilled." And Mary said, "My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord. My spirit rejoices in God my Savior, for he has looked upon his lowly servant. From this day all generations will call me blessed. The Almighty has done great things for me, and holy is his name. He has mercy on those who fear him in every generation. He has shown the strength of his arm, and has scattered the proud in their conceit. He has cast down the mighty from their thrones, and has lifted up the lowly. He has filled the hungry with the good things, and the rich he has sent away empty. He has come to the help of his servant Israel, for he has remembered his promise of mercy, the promise he made to our fathers, to Abraham and his children forever. Mary remained with her about 3 months and then returned to her home. The Gospel of the Lord.
Dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, wish you all a happy feast of the Assumption of our Mother Mary. There is a story for the beginning of the faith in the Assumption. It is said that when Mary died, St. Thomas the Apostle, he was not there. And they buried the Mary. Then when St. Thomas came back, he was insisting that he wanted to see the body of Mother Mary. When they opened the grave, to their surprise, they did not find the body of Mother Mary in the tomb. And Thomas and all the apostles exclaimed that Mary was assumed into heaven. And that is the beginning for this great feast. So from the beginning, the people were believing in the Assumption of Mary. And that is why in 1950, November 1st, Pope Pius XII, through a document, important document, Muni Fecendissimus Deus, declared Mary's Assumption as a dogma of the Church. That means as a Catholic, we all of us are supposed to believe in the Assumption of Mary. There is a distinction between Ascension and Assumption. We celebrate the feast of Ascension of our Lord. The Ascension of our Lord means that He Himself went to heaven. Assumption means Mary was taken up by God to heaven. And this Assumption gives us hope that we all of us also will be assumed into heaven one day. That is the faith, that is the hope. And with that hope and faith only, we celebrate the great feast of Mary, the Assumption of Mary. This feast gives us that we also share the life of Mary, how she lived on the earth. When we live like Mary, we also will be one day assumed into heaven, both body and soul. That is our faith. First and foremost, Mary believed in the word of God. She accepted the will of God when the angel Gabriel appeared and told the message of incarnation. She at once accepted the will of God. She said, "Thy will be done. Thy will be done." Entrusting herself entirely in the hands of God. So we are also called to surrender our life, just like our Mother Mary, to the Heavenly Father. When we surrender ourselves, surely God will strengthen us, God will bless us, God will grant a lot of blessings upon us. So today, Mother Mary is interceding for all of us in heaven. That is the main role of Mary, interceding for us. While on earth, she started to intercede for us. This we clearly see in the marriage at Cana. She started to intercede for us. So today, as we celebrate the Feast of the Assumption, Mary, Mother Mary is interceding for us. Let us entrust all our prayers to God through our Mother Mary. She will intercede for us, and through her intercession, God will bless all of us. So let us pray for one another during this Mass, so that like Mary, all of us also one day may be assumed into heaven. The faithful, through the intercession of Mary, Mother of God, let us bring our needs and the needs of our world before the Lord.
For God's holy church in word and deed, may it proclaim along with Mary the saving power of God, who feeds the hungry and lifts up the lowly, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For governments throughout the world, may the voices of all people, regardless of age, gender, race, or sexual orientation, be valued and welcomed in public discourse, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For persecuted Christians, wherever they may they be protected and strengthened in faith, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all gathered here like Mary, may we be devoted to the Word of God and with joy proclaim it to others, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our loved ones who have died, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those intentions we hold in the silence of our hearts. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. God of justice, along with Mary, we praise your holy name and give you thanks for all you have done for us. Hear our prayers, that following your example, we might also bear Christ to the world in our words and actions. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Ora pro nobis
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. May this oblation, our tribute, our homage, rise up to you, O Lord, and through the intercession of the most blessed Virgin Mary, whom you assumed into heaven, may our hearts aflame with the fire of love, constantly long for you, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For today, the Virgin Mother of God was assumed into heaven as the beginning and image of your church coming to perfection, and a sign of sure hope and comfort to your pilgrim people. Rightly, you would not allow her to see the corruption of the tomb, since from her own body she marvelously brought forth your incarnate Son, the author of life. And so, in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you, and the joy we proclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
Holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. You have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and bread of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring us to the fullness of charity together with Francis our Pope, Bernard our Bishop, and all the clergy, and all of us gathered here before this altar today. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, especially for those people whom we remember and pray. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the Saint Joseph, with the Blessed Apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. The Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, O Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you. Peace be with you, brother.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to a supper.
Lord, I am not worthy to enter my room,
but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body and blood of Christ bring us to everlasting life. Having received the sacrament of salvation, we ask you to grant, O Lord, that through the intercession of the Blessed Virgin Mary, whom you assumed into heaven, we may be brought to the glory of the resurrection through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow your heads for God's special blessing. May God, who through the childbearing of the Blessed Virgin Mary, willed in his great kindness to redeem the human race, be pleased to enrich you with his blessings. Amen.
Amen.
May you know always and everywhere the protection of Mary, through whom you have been found worthy to receive the author of life. Amen. May you who have devotedly gathered on this day carry away with you the gifts of the spiritual joys and the heavenly rewards.
Amen.
Amen. May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Let us go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Hail, Holy Queen, enthroned above, O Maria. Hail, Queen of mercy and of love, O Maria. Triumph, all ye cherubim, sing with us, he said.